Some scholarly authors think that to sound more knowledgeable and authoritative, they must use a lot of technical terms and complex syntax. In scientific papers, we must use some technical terms, which are not a problem if they are either defined or are well known to scientists within the field of study. However, writing that is loaded with unnecessarily long sentences and difficult words will make your readers work harder to understand what you are trying to say. Hi, I'm Karen McKee, and today I'm talking about how to de-jargonize your scientific writing. And at the end of the video, I'll describe a tool that you can use to assess the readability of your writing. One of my favorite examples of difficult-to-understand language was offered by George Otis Smith, former director of the U.S. Geological Survey, in an essay called Plain Geology, published in 1921. The argillaceous character of the formation is very prominent in some localities, although it is usually subsidiary to the arenaceous phase. Smith, who was advocating for use of plain language in scientific writing, offered the following translation of that sentence. At some places, the formation includes considerable clay, but generally it is made up chiefly of sand. There is nothing unscientific, imprecise, or wrong with the second sentence, and it doesn't require additional neurons or a degree in geology to understand. Here are a few more examples. The instrument ceased functioning prior to finalization of the experiment. In plain English, the instrument broke before the experiment ended. Closely controlled growth environments were a necessary prerequisite for confident attainment of valid empirical data regarding plant responses to salinity, which translates to, growth chambers were needed to test plant responses to salinity. Jargon also includes noun phrases, strings of words used as a noun, maximum global sea level rise rate. The temptation here is to create an acronym, MGSLRR, which is even more jargony. Instead, use prepositions and hyphens to break up the noun phrase. Maximum rate of global sea level rise. Scientific authors must, of course, use discipline-specific terms, such as photosystem II, tectonic, or DNA. But they can be conveyed using plain language. Take one of the most famous scientific articles ever written, the one by Watson and Crick and published in Nature in 1953. The first two sentences say, "We wish to suggest a structure for the salt of deoxyribose nucleic acid, DNA. This structure has novel features which are of considerable biological interest." Their straightforward statements tell the reader what the paper is about and its significance. They use an acronym, but it is defined at first mention. In addition to overly technical terms and acronyms, long sentences and a lot of multisyllabic words can hamper comprehension. The Flesch reading ease score, which is calculated based on average sentence length and average number of syllables per word, can be used to assess your writing. Microsoft Word will calculate the readability of a text. To turn it on, go to Word Preferences, Spelling and Grammar, and under Grammar, select Readability Statistics. Here is an abstract. To get to the readability stats for this text, go to Review, and select Spelling and Grammar. In the Editor panel under Insights, select Document Stats. Under Readability is the Flesch Reading Ease score. The higher the number, the higher the reading ease. This score is typical of an academic paper, which is expected to be more difficult to read than a magazine article. Your target score will depend on the audience. A score of 10 to 50 would be readable by a college graduate. A score below 10 would be readable by a professional or someone with an advanced degree. If your text produces a lower score than your target audience, you may want to check for too long sentences or a lot of multisyllabic words and possibly revise to make the text a bit easier to read. Also included is the Flesch-Kincaid grade level, which assesses the reading grade level of the text and is also based on the number of sentences, words, and syllables. Finally, there is also the percentage of passive sentences, which affects readability. Active sentences are usually shorter and easier to comprehend. So if you're not sure about the readability of your writing, these statistics can help you begin assessing what the problem is. Thanks for watching, and please like this video if you found it helpful.